Hi everyone, so here is the setup of our services. I hope you have seen the previous video which talks about the building blocks of the different components. So here we are running this application on the Docker Compose. So we have created a Docker Compose YML and Docker Compose Override. It's just spinning up the two containers, Swiggy microservice and the Postgres, right? Because we need a database to interact with, and the Swiggy microservice is nothing but a Nest.js customized boilerplate. Okay, you can see here I have a config module, database module, Swagger module, and this is my main.ts which is bootstrapping the whole application. Okay, here you can see what do I have is the app module. In the app module, I have the app module is dependent on the domain module. So domain module is where we will write our controllers, services, interceptors, middlewares, everything. And if you have some additional module, then you can actually create here like core module, shared module, because Nest.js design is inspired from Angular. We are creating the modules, we are creating the component, we are creating the controllers, services, middlewares, interceptors, pipes. All these are somehow getting patched with this on top of Node.js, right? Node.js Express. And I really love this design. So in the domain module, you can create the controllers, entities to deal with the database, services to actually fetch the data from the type ORM repositories. We are going to use few things type ORM to deal with the database, Nest.js as a framework to write our REST APIs, Apollo GraphQL to write the queries and mutations, and REST everything is in the Nest.js, like the Swagger module which will expose our APIs to the Swagger, and we are going to use entities. Like we are going to use Postgres and we are going to write entities in the Nest.js service. Here we will put all the entities, their dependencies, their relationship, one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-many. So domain module will be our prime focus area. Here we have the database module and the config module. Database module is nothing but it is giving us the connection object. It is actually initializing the connection for the type ORM, because how we do the database connection in Nest.js service is a little bit different. So here you can see database module, and database module is using dbmodule.forRoot, and we are passing all the entities. So it's actually using type ORM module to initialize our dependencies for the database. So here we are passing all the connection options, which includes synchronization falls, all the connection options, which are like I'm passing the URL, connection URL, not a username, password, database. I mean, you can have only one variable which includes all your configuration. So this is how I'm passing database URL, right? Includes a username, password, connect, host, port, and everything. And I'm using let me just show you .env. So whatever we have in the .env will be populated in the process variables, and all the database configurations will be populated in our DB module. So here we are using it in the config module also. So config module is something which is populating all these configurations for us, like database, log level, New Relic key. So it is actually parsing the DB configuration from environment. It is picking up this process.env.database URL from the .env file. Okay, long story short, this is the boilerplate. This is the custom boilerplate. You can actually clone the repository and you can get started with me on the Swiggy clone app. So we already have written some part of front end, the landing page, and in the services. Now we need to understand the Nest.js. If you are not aware or fully aware how Nest.js framework works, then what you can do is just take one or two videos of my channel only that explains you the basic fundamentals of Nest.js. It is nothing but another way of writing the APIs, and if you already have used Angular, then you will find this quite familiar with you, right? Like creating the modules, services, controllers, and all. Nothing fancy here. So here is our app component. We put the global prefix API v1, and for the Swagger setup we have created like this. So if you just see, it should have started the application on the host port. Let's see what is the host port we have that we can get from the Docker Compose YML. So here you can see it should be in the override. So it is starting the application on localhost 4000, so that we can see. So we can actually do curl request. API v1, and it is redirecting us to some page, right? So we can actually go to the browser and try to see what we are getting. Okay, so what we can do is localhost 4000, that is our endpoint, and here we will get a Swagger spec. You can see for our application. So we have only API v1 health, that's it, right? So we now have a Swagger up and running for our services, and our basic APIs are also up and running. Now next thing which we will start doing is first finalizing the entities. So here I am not expecting that you should be aware about the type ORM, SJS and everything, but if you follow along, you will understand these concepts, like how to write controllers, services, entities, their relationships, and how to actually write the APIs to get the data, right? So here you can see we have app, and inside a domain, we already have created a folder structure. Like I will create a, let's say, the restaurant controller, then restaurant service. There will be a restaurant entity, right? Restaurant has a relationship with all the other entities that we will define here. So request will come to the controller. Controller will do the data validation of the request object. Then it will pass it to the services. Service will talk to the type ORM repositories, will fetch the data and respond it to the client, right? Now our client will be the GraphQL API gateway. And then our next JS, the UI services. UI will actually trigger a query. Okay, give me all the restaurant. So we'll hit the restaurant controller, restaurant service, restaurant repository, and the data from the database. It will send it back to the API gateway. API gateway will just aggregate the data and send it back to the client. Okay, a simple use case. So what I will do is I will quickly build the controllers and services for us. So what we need to do is we can actually do a restaurant controller. First of all, I will just talk about some test controllers, so you will get an idea how to write the controllers and services. And here we can create a test service. And there will be an entity, test entity. And we are using type ORM to run the migration, to run the database sync and everything. So there are two things. Either you write these entities and create the database, or either you write the queries in the migrations and create the database and then write the entities. I do it both way. First, I write all these entities. Then I do the DB sync, I will get the tables, and then I manually put those database table create queries into the migration. So everything is consistent. It will not lead me to do any kind of query mistakes or column name mistakes or column type mistake in the test entity. So what is the use of test entity is to provide the entities. Like we have a test entity, right? So test entity is, we will be using these special annotation @entity in the controller @module @services @injectable. All these annotations we will be using. So if we just simply talks about how to write entity, right? So entity is nothing but the database representation in our system, right? So we have an entity table, but how should we represent that in our code, right? So for that, we actually create these entities. So these entities are plain and simple JavaScript classes, and how we create them is simple. Let's create it. So we use these annotations, and the name of this entity is, there is a name field, and the name of this entity is, let's call it as a test. So it will create a test table in our database. Export default class, let's call it as a test, and here we will define all the columns which you are expecting in this table. So like, let's say primary key will have a title, description, something like that, right? So that we add. So this is primary column is ID, which is a UUID, title, and let's add one more, description. There is no fixed length for this. And two more column, which is created at and updated at, that you can define. So this is a typical structure of any particular entity we are going to have. Now we'll further add the relationships and all these things in this. We also need to import few things like the entities and type ORM column, updated column, all these fields that we will do here. Okay, so it is declaration expected. We have did @ entity. Yeah, this is fine. Maybe TypeScript is taking time to analyze this. So this we have created as an entity. Now we will write a controller. Controller is using @ controller, and controller is nothing but our application routes. Like in Express, we define routes, HTTP GET, POST, POST, DELETE, all these routes. Similarly, you can consider this as a controller. Controller will define all the endpoints. Okay, let's say I have restaurant get, restaurant create, restaurant delete, restaurant update. All these routes we will create, right? So these routes will actually talk to our services. So the basic tags which you need to follow is @ controller, and here you'll define the route. Okay, I already have API v1, so I will just put restaurant. Okay, now similarly I will just define a class, export class restaurant controller. Yes, now I will just define a constructor of my class, and we are going to use the dependency injection here. What do you mean by dependency injection here? Is like we are going to create services, and how to access services without creating the instance. You do the dependency injection here. So I will be doing the dependency injection, and here we will define all our methods. Methods means, okay, let's say I'm just doing get call first. Okay, this is get call public async, simply get. I already know that what I'm getting. I'm getting a restaurant. So I will just say get all. I don't need any input for this, right? What I will do is return this dot some service, and now I will do the dependency injection of that service here. Private read only service, and let's call it as a restaurant service that we will be injecting. Okay, so this dot service dot get all. Okay, this we can return directly. So this, what this method is doing, this method is actually creating a route for us, HTTP GET. This method has created us HTTP GET route. In the Swagger, when we deploy this application and everything after correcting all these things, then it will actually expose this thing. Now we will also talk about further annotations, but let's create a POST. Like if you want to create a restaurant through our APIs, right? So here, instead of get all, we'll just create it as simple create, and here we will actually define the body mapping. Okay, this is I'm getting. So these are the custom annotations to accept a request body from the client, request parameter, query parameter, request and response, right? So I will just say data of type any. So there are no validations for now. But here you can actually create a DTO classes. Okay, I can have, okay, in body there are few things which I wanted to maintain. So you can say DTO, and how you create these DTOs, what you will do is you will create a class in the DTO. DTO.ts. These are nothing but these are the classes. So in Express also we were using these Joey validator for the payload validation, right? Export default class restaurant DTO, and in this class we will define, okay, what is required. Okay, So what I'm saying is name is of type string, but do I want to put some validation like is string? So it means whatever I'm getting, that should be of type string. It is not accepting this. Let's call it as it is defined. That means you have to pass it, okay? And you can also set the minimum length. These are class validator notations. Maybe I'm mistaking this minimum length, and let's put it as a 2. Okay, public name, I will just initialize it. Yeah, so this is the name. Similarly, we can have another argument, string or something. And there are custom annotations, because if we are using Swagger module, it will actually generate everything automatically. So API properties there, I think, which will, you can use that to provide a description for this. Description, I think. Description, and there are other attributes. Okay, do you want to show this required true? Required false, that means this will not be required in the Swagger documentation. It will show it as optional. Okay, similarly, you can actually put the name of restaurant. Same, you can use another property we have, description, right? Required, this is required, both are required true, because we have to show them required true in the Swagger docs. This is description. So now we can expect this DTO is coming in the request payload, and we can use this here. And we just need to import it. Now what it will make sure is we are passing this DTO, otherwise it will send a bad request to us, right? So we have, what we have done is we made the name and description required is defined and minimum length too. So this is our validation criteria for entering to the request. Now instead of service, we will just write a create, and we'll pass this data. Data contains the name and the description. Similarly, you will keep adding these methods. You will have, okay, let's say get, which will be the get by ID, right? And you can also write a DTO for this. Restaurant by ID DTO I will create. And I will make sure that whenever you are passing ID, then that should be of valid ID, right? So I can write a class here, export a default class. And I will make sure that whatever the ID you are passing, that should be of type UUID. UUID of restaurant, and this is, I have the ID, and this should be of UUID. That's enough. It will make sure that whatever you are passing, that should be of type UUID. Restaurant by ID DTO, it is complaining. Okay, we already have export default, so what we can do is export class. I mean, you can do the mix, but let's do them named export. We have to modify our syntax for this one also. So we are importing all the DTOs together. So the another one is restaurant by ID. Okay, we'll import using this. Okay, so this will give us, this will make sure that we are actually passing ID, and here instead of body, it will be verb. Because we are passing not in the body, but we are passing this in the request params. Okay, and then you can just pass params.id is what we are passing. right? Just a glimpse of what we are going to achieve. Here it will be get by ID, which we'll define in the services, right? Now we can actually use some additional controllers and additional annotations, like because my all the APIs will be protected through the bearer token, so I will be using these custom tokens. And to allow these DTO to validate your request, you have to use this validation pipe. Otherwise, it's nothing. You have to use this validation pipe so that your request can be validated against these DTOs. Okay. And at the API level, to populate things in the Swagger doc, you can actually use some custom annotations. Like this is the get all, right? So this API will be exposed through the Swagger spec. So these are some of the tags, like API tag, API operation, API body, HTTP code, what this API will expose. You can actually import all these things. And so we can quickly build all these APIs, get, put, post, delete for each and every entity. I will just resolve all this. These are actually inbuilt things, which we can actually individually import. API operation, API tag. API tag, which it will create the tag in our Swagger doc. Okay, so I mean, I will just offline fix all these inputs. Don't worry about them. Now, next thing we just need is creating the services and now injecting the service here in the constructor like this and calling the particular method. Now service will take care of fetching this data from the particular repositories of type ORM because we already have this entity created. Now the next video, what we will do is we'll write restaurant APIs in actual after creating the restaurant entity in the system. Okay, let's do that in the next video. Thanks everyone.